Hey kids, this week on Connect, we're going to learn that Jesus' disciples know him. But first, let's go praise the Lord.
Look in the mirror, I'm an ordinary kid. I'm just like you, only a little.
Always pursuing me. pursuing me. Your love is chasing, your love is chasing, your love is chasing me. You're always pursuing, always pursuing, always pursuing me. With me, oh. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop, and you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop chasing me.
So what does this thing measure again? Oh, you know what? It actually measures the... Hold on just a second. Hello? You don't say. You don't say! You don't say! You don't say?
Oh, intense. Who was that?
They didn't say.
Our Connect HQ.
Every day we help the people of the world
live God's way.
We look for the links,
make the connection,
and you never know what might happen.
I'm Dot, and this is the time we got to know Tony a little bit better.
Today's the day. Today's... Again? All right. Who's ready for some taffy time with Tony?
I am.
Sounds like fun.
Taffy. Yum.
All right. Looks like... is everyone ready for a time slot here? Let's see. Vanessa, I have you down for 10. Rodney, I have you down for 12.
Little taffy before lunch. I like to live dangerously.
Looks like the only person I don't have on here is you, Dot.
Oh, did I forget to sign up? Well, I've been so busy, it's hard to schedule things.
What have you been busy with?
You know, well...
Ooh, a postcard has just come in.
A postcard! Let me add it. Dear Connect HQ, I want to know God better, but it's hard when I can't see him or hear him. How do I get to know someone who's invisible? Signed, Harvey.
Harvey asks a smart question.
Smart question deserves a smart answer.
We can figure it out. I'll stand right here all day if I have to.
Oh, great, great. I was gonna have taffy time with Tony in the observatory, but I can move it in here. What time do you want to get started?
Professor Malcolm's really smart. I'll go to the rad room and see if he has any answers.
Okay, I'll put you down for 11. She's gonna come at 11.
So, what do you think, Professor Malcolm?
That's a really important question.
That's why I'm here.
The best way, the only way really, to know God better is become one of Jesus' disciples.
I know Jesus had 12 disciples that were his trusted friends. Is it like that?
We can be disciples too. A disciple is someone who follows someone else, gets to know them, and tries to live like them.
There's that word know.
Yes, Jesus' disciples know him. The more time you follow Jesus, the better you will know him.
But how do I get to know him?
You need to use the right tools.
I don't understand.
Let me ask you this. If I wanted to study and find all of that bacteria and other organisms living in my cup of coffee,
ew!
What instrument would I use?
The microscope. It makes tiny things like bacteria look bigger.
That's right. And the more powerful the microscope, the better I can see.
But Jesus isn't tiny like a bacteria, is he?
No, but there are still tools we can use to help us see him.
Like what?
Like prayer, talking with Jesus. Like worship, celebrating Jesus.
Like reading the Bible.
We can really get to know Jesus very well by doing those things.
I just love taffy.
I love taffy too.
See, I didn't know that. We're getting to know each other better already.
Mm-hmm.
So where are you from originally?
I'm from.
What?
Where are you from originally?
Okay, it's hot. It's taffy in my mouth.
Oh, no. I have a bit simple money.
Okay.
Or thank you. Hey.
I found this great verse about getting to know Jesus in the book of Philippians, chapter 3, verse 10.
Let's hear it.
Philippians 3, 10.
Philippians 3, 10.
I want to know Christ better.
I want to know Christ better.
I want to know the power that raised him from the dead.
I want to know the power that raised him from the dead.
I know Christ is Jesus, but could you explain the part about power?
Just like the first disciples experienced God's power when he raised Jesus from the dead, we can experience God's power too, the more we follow Jesus. God's power answers prayers. God's power works miracles. God's power changes us to be able to live God's way. Those are just a few examples of God's power.
Wow.
We're sort of like these paper clips, right? And God is powerful like this magnet here. And the magnet has a power, but the paper clips are too far away to experience it. It's the same with us. If we don't get to know God, we may never experience his power. But if we get to know Jesus and follow him more and more, we get closer to him. The closer we become, the more we see, really see, and experience God's power.
Where is Dot? She was supposed to be here 10 minutes ago. Hey, Maurice.
Hey, Tony. I was just finishing up some routine maintenance on the ductworks. I thought I'd drop in and see if I can still sign up for some taffy time with Tony.
Well, yeah, actually, Dot didn't show up for her time slot, so go ahead and have a seat. But it's no longer taffy time with Tony. It's now taco time with Tony because we couldn't understand each other with taffy in our mouths.
Hey, I love tacos.
So you always been into tools and fiction stuff?
Mm.
My third grade teacher's name was Mrs. Stenzel. Why do you ask? Mm. I always wanted to be an astronaut too.
Mm.
I think we're getting to know each other really well. It's 11:15. Oh, are you good?
Mm-hmm.
You're looking at your watch. Do you need to leave?
Tony wanted everyone to meet with him today.
Oh, yes. My taffy time with Tony is at 2 o'clock. I can't wait. I love taffy. It's so delicious. You don't want to go?
Can I confess something to you? I don't really like taffy. It hurts my teeth.
I don't think it's about the taffy. Tony wants to get to know everyone better. I think you should keep your appointment.
Maybe you're right. It's just, I think I need another example of knowing God by seeing his power.
Of course. I'll demonstrate with my mobile wind machine.
That's a mobile wind machine?
You can't see wind. It's invisible. But you can certainly feel its power.
I don't feel anything.
That's because you're too far away. But see, or rather feel, as it comes closer, the closer it gets, the more you experience its power.
Dude, I get it.
The more you get to know God, the more you feel his power too. The power of his Holy Spirit that lives inside of us when we choose to follow Jesus.
This turkey is great.
Yeah, it's really quiet.
I meant it tastes good.
Oh, I'm sorry, I must be feeling sleepy or something.
Professor Malcolm said there's this thing in turkey called tryptophan, or something like that. It makes you sleepy. Have you ever heard of tryptophan? Tony?
Train time with Tony, woo-hoo!
The first disciples had it easy. They could talk to Jesus and watch him every day here on earth.
Yes, it would be nice to be able to see Jesus. But think about this. When Jesus was here on earth, he could only be in one place at a time. So only a small number of people could really get to know him.
That's true.
How awesome is it that Jesus made it possible now for all of us to spend time with him, to get to know him?
But not everyone does spend time with Jesus.
Even when Jesus was here on earth, not everyone who met him or heard him speak or saw his miracles followed him.
Why not?
They just didn't have the right soil.
What?
You see, we're like soil. And then there's these birds and rocks and... Here. Jesus tells it better than I do.
This is the story about the God who loves us in the Bible. We find truth and purpose to love God and love others. We're searching God's word for things to discover. This book is alive, full of answers and godly advice. This book is alive. See the wonderful stories inside. Every day I'm searching, read through history and poetry. How much Jesus loves me. God's great story lives. There's no other book like this. This book is alive.
Jesus liked to teach by telling stories. His stories were called parables because they always had a hidden meaning that taught a lesson.
Listen. A farmer went out to plant some seeds. As he scattered the seeds across the field, the seeds fell in all different places. Some of the seeds fell on the hard path, and the birds came and ate them. Some of the seeds fell on the shallow, rocky soil. But once the hot sun came up, the baby plants wilted and died because they didn't have deep roots. Some of the seeds fell among thorns. The thorns grew up and choked out the baby plants, and they died too. Some of the seeds fell on good soil, and they grew up to be healthy plants that made 100 times more seeds. Anyone who is really listening will understand.
Jesus' disciples came and asked him, "Why do you use parables to teach the people?"
Peoples whose hearts are open to me will understand the secrets of the kingdom of heaven. I'll give them the ability to understand. But to those whose hearts are closed, they won't get it at all. They'll hear my words, but won't understand them. Your eyes will be blessed for really looking for me. Your ears will be blessed for really listening to me. Here, let me explain the parable and you will see what I mean. Like the farmer spreading the seeds, I'm here to spread the good news about God's love for the world. The seed represents that message and how people respond to it in all different ways. The seeds on the hard path are like the people who hear God's word, but close their hearts to it and don't let it sink in. It's easy for the devil to snatch away the truth planted in their hearts. The seeds on the shallow, rocky soil are like people who received the message with joy. But since they don't continue to learn and grow, they don't last long. They give up as soon as they have problems or things get tough. The seeds among thorns are like people who hear God's word, but then let the message get crowded out by distractions and worries and chasing after stuff, so they never grow or put it into action. But the seeds that fell on good soil are like those who truly hear and understand God's word. When they put it into practice, they spread the good news to others, and 100 times more people hear the message too.
What kind of soil will you be? If you really listen and really look and really open your heart to God, you can be the good soil. God's word will grow inside of you, and you can help spread the good news about Jesus all over the world.
So, knowing Jesus isn't just hearing him once and then we're done. We have to continue getting to know him and trusting him.
Even when hard times come, like the rocky soil.
Jesus' disciples know him, and getting to know him is a lifelong process that requires spending time with him.
Just like getting to know anyone.
Like Tony.
See, my problem was requesting food. You can't understand anyone with a taco in their mouth. You gotta do an activity to really get to know somebody. I am loving this toe touch time with Tony. So, Rodney, where do you see yourself in 5 years?
5 years? I like to...
Well, you can stop and catch your breath if you need to.
I like to be in better shape.
Like me. Dot, you made it!
Am I too late for taffy time with Tony?
Well, it's no longer taffy time with Tony. I had to kind of revise things a few times.
I can see that. I'm sorry I didn't come sooner. I didn't realize why this was so important to you.
But now you do?
Yes. If someone is important to you, you want to make the effort to get to know them.
Thanks, Dot. You're important to me, too. So, how about this? Are you ready for some trampoline time with Tony?
That sounds like fun.
Okay, good. Let me just find a trampoline. Give me a few hours.
A few hours? Maybe we should skip the trampoline then.
Okay. Well, how about tuba time with Tony?
No.
Toothpaste time with Tony.
Ew, no.
Ten tall, tasty tangerine time with Tony?
How about just time with Tony?
I like that. That sounds good.
Hi, I'm Dot. Thanks for your question about getting to know God better. I have good news. You can if you really want to. In the book of Philippians it says, Philippians 3:10, I want to know Christ better. I want to know the power that raised him from the dead. Christ is Jesus. We can get to know Jesus every day. When we know Jesus better, we will also know how great God's power is. The word of God is like seeds that a farmer throws on the soil. Some people hear about Jesus, but they never take the time to get to know him better. We want to be good soil that hears and listens, gets excited, but then continues to get to know Jesus and trust him. When we do that, God's power grows amazing things in our lives. Just like a microscope is a tool we can use to see certain things, we have tools to help us know God better. Tools like prayer, worship, and reading the Bible, God's word. I learned today that the key to getting to know Tony better was to just spend time with him. That's how it is with Jesus too. The more time we spend with him, the better we'll know him. Jesus' disciples know him. A disciple is a follower. The more you follow Jesus, the better you'll know him. The more you know Jesus, the better follower you'll be. Works out pretty good. I hope this answers your question, Harvey, and helps you to get to know God a whole lot better. And remember, Connect HQ is here to help you.
I am so glad that Dot finally agreed to visit with Tony and spend some time with him. Tony just wanted to get to know Dot, just like Jesus wants to get to know us, and we need to get to know him. You can spend time with Jesus by reading the Bible, by singing praise and worship, by praying. Take some time today to spend with Jesus. You know, the closer you get to Jesus, it's like this fan. You know, you have to get really close to feel the powerful wind. Just like that, you get to closer to Jesus and you can feel the powerful Holy Spirit. You can sense his presence, and it's just a peace that you'll never imagine. It's wonderful. So today, spend some time with God, and he'll enlighten you. And he'll show you his grace and his mercy and his powerful love. Okay, till next time. See you later. Bye. Hey, kids. Pastor Kathy here. This week on The Loop, we're going to learn about stories. And not just any stories, good stories. But first, let's go praise the Lord.
That's a Snapchat. Boomerang with the praise and the right back. Man, we higher than the sky, no turn back. If it be our last night, leave it all here. No fear, be clear, this is your year. Let go of anything that isn't God's steer. Visine with a dream, and it's so clear. Yeah, so clear. And you know wherever you go, I'ma stick close, they gon' think we a duo. Bond so tight, hug it out like a sumo. And I never think twice, you the boss of my life, no Hugo. And this world not down with us. They can try to limit faith, but it's down to us. Man, love so deep, not a game to us. When the blessing come down, man, the praise go up, yeah.
Sky, your love is deeper than the sea. Your grace is washing over me and calling me your own, your own. Higher than the sky, your love is deeper than the sea. Your grace is washing over me and calling me your own.
here?
This is just a simple, silly story.
Oh no, this card says we have to kick it up a notch.
Uh-oh.
Hang on for the loop.
4, 3, 2, 1.
Okay, so in most word games, you don't know the story, but you get to choose the words. But we're changing the game. This time, you get to know the story, but we choose the words. I thought it was gonna be a straightforward story.
It never is.
I'm Ricky.
I'm Jamie.
Randomly place the word cards on the board to tell your new story. Then you'll reveal the words and act it out.
Oh, okay, so we're gonna like create like a skit? It's not gonna be eating disgusting things or wearing disgusting things?
That has yet to be determined, Jamie. So one by one, we are going to fill the story. So Jamie.
All right, I'm just gonna go for right on the top. So we have our noun.
Next one is part of the body. And while I'm here, I'm gonna go with an explanation.
Oh, perfect, that's great. So adjectives.
Verb and noun. Oh.
What, not this one?
I don't know.
Okay, all right, I switched it, remember.
No, Jamie, don't you put this on me.
I switched it.
No. And then the last one.
All right.
Okay, so that is our story.
I hope it's a good one. We tell stories every day.
But telling people about how Jesus changed your life can sometimes feel difficult.
What if you say the wrong words?
What if you sound like a know-it-all or a dork?
Let's get some tips on how to tell the story of what you love.
Jump Scare Jimmy? Hello? I thought I called him. Jump Scare Jimmy. Hello?
Boo!
Jump Scare Jimmy. Got me again. Why are you so good at that? I was ready to take out my computer.
Got
oh my
you.
Good. You got me good.
Fooled you. Got you, Judo Bob.
Wait, what have you been up to? Where are you at right now?
Well, this is my home, my humble abode. You know, I've just been practicing my jump scares lately. I'm not by myself, though. I have my cat, Douglas. I've been practicing them on him, and it's been pretty fun. But he's a good guy. We like to have fun around here.
Does he do jump scares too? Have you taught him your ways?
You know, I've tried. It's tough to teach a cat jump scares because they sleep about 18 hours a day. Wow. What have you been up to, Judo Bob?
Judo Bob's just been training his Padawans. So judo has been a passion of mine since I was, you know, just a little dude. Judo is massive discipline. So you have to pour yourself into it, and it's humbling at times, especially when people put, you know, good moves on you. Yeah. But you have to persevere and you have to get better. It's kind of, you know, the same about Jesus, even like learning perseverance and learning humility. What about you? What got you into jump scare?
Oh, buddy, as soon as I was born, my parents were like, "Ooh," I scared them right away on day one, and I love it. So jump scares are scary. We know that, at least if you do them right.
Right.
But they're also fun. After you scare somebody, you still share some joy. That joy is part of sharing Jesus, too. Joy comes from Jesus, and yes, it's all about sharing jump scares and joy and Jesus. And that's just what I'm about, baby.
Where's Douglas around? I'd love to say hi to him.
You know, I was looking for him earlier because I should feed him. I'm going to try to track him down, but it was still good talking to you, Judo Bob.
You too, Jump Scare Jimmy.
Douglas, where are you, buddy? Douglas, oh!
All right, so we have all of the elements on the board. Let's start telling our story, shall we? One day, Ricky and Jamie wanted a new challenge. So Ricky said, let's dump a sagging balloon full of pickle relish.
Oh my god, a sagging balloon on our, I'm assuming, head.
Shoulders!
Oh, okay.
And Jamie, what do you think your response to that is?
Mozart's armpits. That's hard to say.
All right.
Oh, we're doing it right now. You know, it's more solid than I thought it would be. I thought it would be much more liquidy.
Save me.
We can do it. I'm really sorry. Oh, it's bubbling. Can you see this? Oh, it's coming out like a little.
Oh my goodness, no. Okay, here we go. My goodness.
Mozart's armpit.
That doesn't sound like something I'd say.
It was fun, but not very noisy.
It was too noisy almost.
So Jamie said, I know, we can.
Anything but eat.
Smash! Yay, that's what I was thinking. A banana? Chunky gravy boat until it's all gone. What? This is not like a traditional gravy boat. This is a literal USA boat. It's gonna get all over the place. Yay!
Okay, here we go. All right, this is a gravy boat.
Yes. Oh my gosh, that was amazing. Oh my gosh!
I think that did it. Okay, and that was fun, but still not aggressive. I beg to differ.
Yeah.
Ricky said, hey, we've always wanted to.
All right, remember, Ricky.
No.
Pretty sure this is the
Jamie.
Verb that you made me switch it to.
Devour. Oh, no. A pizza. Let it be a pizza.
Yeah, I'm sure
a pepperoni
they put a pizza.
A garden pot of grape jelly and a skull full of unflavored gelatin at the same time.
Seriously, I might gag.
Okay, listen, look at this. Just look, it's just the bounce. All right, 1, 2, 3, go, Jamie.
Oh.
Isn't this crazy? It's like so crazy that we're devouring. Gross.
What's in it?
All right, fine. 1, 2, 3, oh. Oh. Oh, God, this
get
is
some more
this
of. That's gross.
I'm just mixing it up.
Things are different in 2020.
But make sure that in your hearts you honor Christ as Lord. Always be ready to give an answer to anyone who asks you about the hope you have. Be ready to give the reason for it, but do it gently and with respect. 1 Peter 3:15.
Hey, my name is Riley and I used to be a gymnast. And used to is like the key phrase right there, like I'm no longer a gymnast. Like, it's been a long time since I've been a gymnast. I'll try to show you some moves if I can, okay? But you can't judge me. No judgment zone, safe place. I feel good about it. Ah, oh my goodness. Okay, don't try any of this at home. Okay, ready? Splits time, here we go. Full, okay. All perfect for me, you can't see. These awesome splits. But trust me, I'm doing them. Okay, you get the point. In gymnastics, a big skill that you have to master is learning how to flip. This is as terrifying as it sounds. It's basically launching your body into the air and just hoping that you have enough momentum to land it. Like, yeah, super scary. I was working on the skill and trying to master it. I would fall so many times. Like, go for it, fall. Go for it, fall. Go for it, fall. Face plant, all the things. Super embarrassing, just really messy, really wrong. I got it wrong so many times, but there was one day where I was like, you know what? I'm tired of falling. I'm tired of face planting. Today is gonna be my day. And I feel like I walked into the gym with more like swagger. There had to be some like really cool, like motivational music behind me, like in my brain, like the da-da-da-da. I had all this courage and I was like, you know what? Today is gonna be the day. And so I get ready, I prep myself, I'm on the mat, I'm ready to throw it, the moment happens, and I land it, yeah! The crowd goes wild. Everybody was cheering. My whole teammates were cheering. My coach was cheering. We were all so excited for me to land that flip. And it's not because I just landed that flip, but it's because everyone in that room understood how many times I had tried and tried again, and how many times I had gotten it wrong, and how many times it had been super messy and face plans and all the things. They knew that. And so it made landing it for the first time so much sweeter. My mom took me out for ice cream, and that's my favorite thing. So like, it was a good day for me. And I think that it's the same with Jesus. Listen, you and I, we can pretend like we're perfect and we've always been awesome and we've always had it figured out and we always make the right choices. I could have told you that I was born doing backflips. Like, I was born, and then before I could walk, I was backflipping. But those don't make very good stories because they're not God's story. God's story goes, you were reckless, you were messy, you made mistakes, you were rescued, you were loved by me, and now you're restored. You are awesome because of my love. And that's what evangelism is it's telling God's story and letting Jesus be the hero. It doesn't have to be over-exaggerated. It doesn't have to be some heartbreaking story. And it doesn't have to be perfect. Sometimes people just need to hear about the hope that you get to feel each and every day because of Jesus. God's good story invites us into a world that is much larger than us. So Loop, let me ask you this. What story are you telling?
Oh, it's like gotten a little crusty.
Yeah, it's like congealing. Huh. Well, the awesome news is we all have different stories.
So what's your story, Ricky? How was Jesus a game changer in your life?
So I didn't necessarily grow up like in the church, mm-hmm. I guess kind of like around the church. And so I think I had a pretty different view of Christians kind of growing up. Like I thought that they were kind of hypocritical, like people would say one thing or do one other thing. I don't know, so I was keeping my distance for like part of my life. But then I actually met a really cool group of Christians who were like actively following Jesus, and like they made it known, and they also were very, I guess, just different, and just how they were living out their life, like being a Jesus follower, made a huge impact on me. And so then I became a Jesus follower myself.
That's awesome.
How about you?
So I actually did grow up in church, and I say in church, but I mean multiple churches, because my dad was a music minister, and so we would travel all around the state going to different churches. There was one Sunday where we were visiting a church, and I decided to follow Jesus at that church. And one of the biggest impacts that following Jesus has had on my life, the biggest game changer that I've experienced, is that just because I'm a Christian doesn't mean that I haven't gone through a roller coaster. Doesn't mean that I haven't had highs and haven't had lows. My faith in Jesus, it may not necessarily make my life easier, but it makes it possible to face those highs and those lows. So.
Amen. That's awesome.
Thank you. Thank
you. Well said. I think it's natural to be worried about evangelism because, I mean, it's a big word. Have you tried spelling it? But it's also a lot of responsibility. And the important thing to remember is when you're sharing your story, make sure you make Jesus the hero.
Yeah, and I think we forget sometimes that we do that with our words, and sometimes we tell the story with our actions.
This idea for a painting of, you know, how do I share what Jesus means to me without using words? Really sharing the struggle of what life can be, but then also the promise of the new life that Jesus brings throughout the week, as I'm creating this painting, I had neighborhood kids just stopping by and asking questions and just really wondering what I was doing, why I was doing it. So I finished the painting. I'm looking at the final piece and just seeing what God was able to do through the struggle of it, the creative process. And these neighborhood kids are there with me, and they're asking all these questions about it, really wondering why it means so much to me. And what was amazing to see in that moment was God was preparing them all along to receive Him, to make that decision to see Jesus actually impact their eternity forever. Just because I decided to create and express something that was so meaningful to me. And that day, it shifted completely for them.
Oh, yay! I'm so glad that it's on our set.
Me too. I mean, it fits perfectly. It feels like it's been here forever. I love it. Always be ready to give an answer to anyone who asks about the hope you have.
And when you share your story, make Jesus the hero.
Everyone is looking for hope, so share it.
This, this we made? Ew! Tells quite the story.
Yeah, it was very, aw, beautiful.
Share your story, and until next time,
enjoy the ride!
Get creative. What is one way that you can use your story to show Jesus to people this week? Because each of us have unique gifts, passions, stories that we can use to show other people the love of God. What is it going to look like for you? Let me pray. Heavenly Father, I thank you so much that you have created each of us uniquely. You have given us talents that we get to use to help other people. And so I pray that we would be looking for opportunities to use what you've given us to show your love to others. I pray all of this in Jesus' name. Remember, get creative. What is one unique way that you can use your story to show Jesus to someone else? See you next time.
Wow, that was an amazing story. The word evangelism can make you a little worried because it's a big word with a big responsibility attached to it. But it doesn't have to be. You just simply need to tell your story and give others hope that Jesus can help them. Tell them how Jesus has helped you. Tell them how Jesus gave you love and took away your anxiety and gave you grace. Tell your story and make Jesus the superhero. Be a game changer and tell others about Jesus. Okay, till next time, see you later. Bye! Wow, I'm so glad that Dot finally had some Tony time. You know, Tony just wanted to get to know her better. And you do that by spending time with him. We need to encourage each other and tell our... to know her better. And you do that... I am so... Ugh. Hey kids, this week on Connect, we're going to learn that Jesus knows... Well, of course Jesus knows his disciples. It's the disciples that know Jesus better. And you do that by spending time with each other when you do that. Because that's what you do when you want to spend...